It seems odd to say, on a cold, wet, pervasively gray day, how wonderful it is to be here. But that's the feeling. Feeling of wonder and beauty. On a day like today, the weatherman or weather person would say apologetically, we're in for miserable weather. Sorry, it's not sunny. It's just coming up that that's the weather of thinking. You can almost see the clouds forming, the thought clouds. It's not the cloud outside the window, shining through the giant oaks of the hedgerow. It's not the tapping, dripping noise. It's not sitting, feeling the chair, the cushion, the hands in the lap. Hearing the bird. Walking up the hill this morning, moisture everywhere, branches with fat, clear droplets of water, branches of bushes and trees, wet leaves underfoot. Almost felt like an invasion, an invasive thing to walk on the ground because we're trampling it down. It's so soft, so saturated. Of course, the ground gave some back. Mud on the trousers. Bubbling creeks. And the roar of the cascade. Walking up to the pond. Gray cloud everywhere. Gray, still water. And the cattails bent down. Just incredible beauty. And a pervasive quiet, which isn't the absence of noise. What came to mind or what popped into the mind to talk about today, to look at a little bit, to see what comes up, is attention. And somehow in the mind, the word attention was amended to be simple attention. And then immediately the question comes up, is this something that the person speaking is recommending? Is it a practice? A way? Well, we'll look at that. Anything can become that. But at this moment, we can look together. Does it take a special exertion or effort to listen? Rain dropping? Breathing. If I think, well, I'm not really hearing it, I've got to do better, I'm not getting this, then that efforting, that exerting takes center stage. For some reason, there's a memory here, and not of great insight or a deep coming to, but of sitting on a long afternoon, a rainy afternoon, when we were going to retreats at a YWCA camp in a nearby lake, and trying so hard to listen to that rain, to be attentive. And the incredible physical memory, let's use that phrase, of straining to do this right. And there is a kind of listening in that. Shutting off the thoughts, clamping down, we could say it works. But for some reason, for that memory to stay so vividly, it works in a way that wasn't terribly pleasant. Not that we're trying to engender pleasant feelings, but it was clear that there wasn't a fullness of listening there. Perhaps that's the insight. This straining. To be somebody in something. To be an intender. And to reap the benefits thereof. A whole complicated movement around something so incredibly simple as rain sound, gentle dripping, so is this a practice? Something that is being recommended? Or is it possible I want to say that this is our natural state, to look, to listen, to be. When we're not intentionally complicating, striving, improving and altering this picture of ourselves, like something carried in the wallet, a fading, cracked picture, always needing to be refreshed. So it could be a simple and natural attention. Something that arises when self-preoccupation is not taking all of the space, all of the energy. Whether this is true or false, or neither, is not for this person to say. The looking is here at this moment. There's no need to create a formula or a method. Caw, caw. Drip. One thing that came up after the opening remarks last night as I was remembering what was said. Quite a bit of talk about silence. But frequently, coming to retreat, perhaps getting out of the car, and at first, one's really taken by this open landscape, this quiet hillside, only a few gunshots this morning. But sitting down in a quiet room, it might be kind of obnoxious to hear somebody talk about silence when the mind is just churning with thoughts, if that's the case. There does seem to be something coming from our busy lives. Taking some time out, and then all of this stuff that hasn't been seen is coming into view. And the thought, oh, I'm just drowning in these thoughts. I can't even hear this dripping, the crow, or sense the breathing, the heart beating. What am I doing wrong? Am I a hopeless case? So this is what's being wondered about here. In the simplicity, in the openness, of a new kind of attention, an unforced attention. And these thoughts, the reactions to the thoughts, be seen in a new way, just as they are, with no effort to rid oneself of the burden of thinking or adding more thinking about the thinker. How that thinker is no good at meditation, or meditation isn't right for this person. But just listening. What's going on here? And maybe in that listening, there's already a little change of what? A little change. The listening is taking the energy, is the energy. There's energy available in that listening. And the thinking doesn't have to be the enemy, to be shunned or to be afraid of, just to be seen. What's going on here? Look at what grabs us. It's usually what's observed here, thought about something we call me. There's subtle reference points. And this isn't to create another should, how we should be. We should be getting rid of this me. Immediately the mind likes to look at things in terms of what's good and what's not good for me. So it's good for me not to think about me. But keeping the field open. Not by force, but by the wonder of interest. So maybe it's letting the field be open, not keeping it. Hearing these thoughts as if for the first time. In all their grossness and their subtlety. And seeing the mischief that occurs. Maybe mischief is too strong a word, but seeing what occurs. Remembering what someone said to me, how they crossed me when I was so intent on a certain course, and the energy is aroused, ready to take action. Not to be pushed around. But all in this arena of thinking, picture of the person that did me wrong, perhaps a little story about them, the way they are, they always do this way, and the picture of the suffering me. seeing that, watching the play, possibly without jumping in, say relinquishing one's role as the lead actor for a moment. To see what's really going on in a deeper way. And perhaps not needing to add more content, more story. Just watching the thoughts. But letting the watching occur in quiet. It sounds contradictory, the noisy mind seen in silence. But it's the jumping in, the adding more fuel to the story that sustains. The sense that this drama is real. Perhaps there's a natural quieting in direct observation. In that quiet, there can be a different kind of seeing, a different kind of thought coming up, seeing how this person, what the real role was in the remembered drama, or something a little closer to what the real role was. And it's a wonderful freeing not to have to blame others, to blame oneself, but to see a little bit about how we blunder along. When we're confused, when the space is constricted, to see it without, if possible, further commentary. This is what happened in bumbling and confusion. And now there's some seeing, some insight. So thought says, okay, guilt. I've got to feel guilty about what I did. But maybe in this quiet listening, there's some, say, ability to discern the seductiveness and the falsity of that thought. The guilting is just more thinking about what might have been. So in this simple listening, simple attending, is there a doer, an attender, a listener? Dripping. It takes thought to create the picture of the listener, doesn't it? Breathing. We could say in and out, shallow or deep, yogic. Asthmatic. My breathing. Listening to your breathing. Without these descriptions, it's not our doing, is it? If we were doing it, we'd probably forget. It's amazing, and it's a wonder. Something so utterly simple. We can see that. It's so usually unnoticed. We have so much to do, so much work, so much relationship, so little time. One of the wonderful things about retreat is finding a new way of working. Working in silence. Feeling the vegetables or the paring knife. Watching the peels fall off. And yet we can see all of the dramas of the working life. Am I doing well? Am I a good worker? Will people like me? Perhaps next retreat I'll get a promotion. From toilets to kitchen. But in this silence, there's so much room, so much space for looking. To see what is a show. As a show, And perhaps at times, not jumping on stage, not getting caught in the content, staying here, the simplicity of a very wide and open view. An attention that doesn't require anything. That's natural and simply available. There's even a little bit of openness and curiosity. An openness to discover what's going on here from moment to moment. We'll end here for today.